Hello everyone, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. Many people have asked to see household ammonia put in a test tube and superheated. Now the container I showed at the beginning claims it is pure ammonia, but that's not true. This is actually a solution of water and ammonia, creating what most people call aqueous ammonia or ammonium hydroxide. You'll notice that I pulled away the torch for a second. That was to light some sulfur, creating a sulfur dioxide cloud around this experiment, and we'll explain more about that later on. Now, since this was a relatively short experiment, only lasting about a minute and a half, I decided not to compress or speed up the footage at all to show you exactly what it looks like in real time. You'll notice that I have kind of a silly little mounting device for these test tubes, and it's kind of designed to do exactly what you see right there. I call it the wobbly wire, and it kind of agitates and disperses the heat a little better than if it was just stationary. Now you'll notice, if you look closely, a red material underneath the cap. You can see it kind of protruding by the neck of the cap of the vial. That is high temperature silicone. The cap alone cannot withstand the pressure, it would just leak out. So I have to put a silicone plug in the top of these things. Now I found that this silicone plug is a pretty consistent blowout point. The plug will usually blow out first before the glass actually ruptures. That's not always the case though. A lot of people ask, what did it smell like? And I'm never close enough to smell it. You can see how much glass fragmentation blows out here. It goes about 20 feet or so, and it is very sharp, and I don't want to be anywhere near that. Now, despite the silicone blowout plug, that didn't work, and the glass tube actually exploded this time. Now also take note that the cloud you see is not all visible water vapor. Now ammonia in the presence of sulfur dioxide creates something called ammonium sulfite, and that's that white visible cloud. It's actual smoke, not a visible water vapor that you would normally see if it was just pure water. Now in the presence of pure ammonia or anhydrous ammonia, that cloud would have been a lot bigger and a lot wider, but we still saw it, and I'm just happy with the results. Thanks for watching.